committed sins, and they think that those sins have also been mentioned in the Holy Quran and the Bible, and they believe in all these stories and tales which have been attributed to certain very great prophets of Allah, so that almost all the prophets mentioned in the Holy Quran have been attributed with some sin, some crime. Ahmadis do not believe in this, and Ahmadis defend the position of each and every prophet in this regard. But this is again not the forum for me to discuss all this. At the appropriate time, I have discussed it before and I will discuss it again, but not here at this forum. It's a much longish answer that you expect, one should expect from this question. What they have written about the prophets, what are the sources from which they have taken that material, and why we reject that as false and things. So even I will not be able to finish this regarding one prophet here.
We have been telling the world,
and the world knows it, that and this is another opposition. But if you consider yourself the world, then I'll tell you again perhaps sometimes, but not now. As far as the rest of the world is concerned, I tell you, we have been telling this. I have even mentioned it in some of my sermons and my question answer sessions. This has been discussed at some length. But at this time, I don't want to repeat all this, because as I told you, we are short of time, and this is not a question which can occupy so short a space. For what?
That's why I asked in the meeting, forgiveness for erroneously if I ask any question.
No, there's no question any forgiveness. This is just a simple statement of things. You are making and I am answering you in the same way. Why should you keep on craving forgiveness for things you have not committed? In this regard, you are immune completely.
If there is time, should I ask a small question
now? All right, please, go ahead. Yes. Yes. What is mentioned?
Bee.
That's how it means, yes. Honeybee, yes.
Honeybee is
yes.
Mentioned in the Holy Quran.
Yes.
Would Hazur kindly let us know if the same God is mentioned in the Holy Quran or
what?
In the Hadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam?
So, what is it? Silkworm. If silkworm has also been mentioned. I don't see, silk has been mentioned, of course, but not the silkworm. No. Of course it is useful, but there are also other useful things which have not been mentioned, particularly by name, I mean. In principle, the Holy Quran goes on repeatedly making the claim that Allah has made everything useful and for a set purpose, and everything serves a purpose and is subservient to the cause of man. Everything has been created for the sake of man. So under this larger claim, in fact, everything which is created is useful. It is serving some useful purpose. So on that ground, you cannot eliminate anything. If every useful thing has to be mentioned by name by the Holy Quran, then the whole world of creation, animate as well as inanimate, has to be mentioned by name. It's not possible. I mean, it's possible for Allah, but not possible for you to read through all this. Silk one? Of course silk is mentioned, but why are you so particularly interested in silkworm being mentioned? Of course it does. Other things producing other things. Why shouldn't they be mentioned? And I replied only. No. No, Hariya has been mentioned, but the silkworm is not mentioned. I mean, again, with due apologies to you, of course. Unfortunately, I can't find any reference in the Holy Quran to silkworm. And we feel so dejected and sad about it that I'm surprised why you are taking such deep interest in silkworm alone, of all the things. Of course the product is good, but don't you think cotton is also good? Isn't it better than silk? In so many ways. I know that he also admits it, but the point is that everything, all the factors responsible for producing cotton should also be mentioned, shouldn't they? Why not?
Can I come?
Yes, please go ahead.
Those are mosquitoes mentioned.
Yes?
The small thing mentioned like mosquito.
Yes? And also an ant is mentioned, a small thing like ant. Isn't it? There is a smaller thing than mosquito. An ant has been mentioned. And also bacteria have been mentioned under the name of jinn. Yet, unfortunately for you, the silkworm has not been mentioned. So what is the big objection? Yes, yes, please. Sorry. Question.
Good product of the emergent flow that produce up one product is allowed for us to use and produce up the other is not, if it was mentioned in the Bhagavad-gita.
No, it is not mentioned, so the question drops automatically. You know, I know what is bothering you. You are not being able to explain yourself. You think that the honeybee is mentioned only because it is producing honey. And it's a useful thing. So you think that silk is even more useful perhaps, or at least at par with honey. Not much, much lower in order, much lower. So why you think much lower in order is not mentioned? This is the question. After you put the question in its true perspective, it finishes. It dies a natural death.
My question and answer are satisfied, but if there is somebody else's